say.
What is that?
Tom Smith Dent.
When is your birthday? What day?
Geek.
When is your birthday?
Tom Petit.
What day? December?
10th.
December 10th. And how old are you going to be?
6.
Oh, you're 38, now you're going to be 39.
Nine.
That's right, you can't cheat in that film. Our son is a real person, and public awareness is really lacking in spite of the fact individuals with Down syndrome have been part of society going back several hundred years. So I say he's a real person, he does real person things, but yet society does not recognize that. They build barriers. Tom has no difficulty, no problems having Down syndrome, but society has problems with Tom having Down syndrome. We had a wonderful experience a few years back. We were rollerblading in Assiniboine Park. This older gentleman came over to me and he says, "Is that your boy?" And I said, "That's my son, yes." And he says, "What's his name?" And I said, "Well, why don't you ask him?" And Tom says, "Tom." And he says, "How old are you?" And Tom mentioned that. And he says, "He's doing a wonderful thing, skating." And then his eyes teared up. And he looked at me, he says, "I had a brother like that." And he says, "Nobody," and his exact words were, "nobody would let him do anything." And with that, he sort of went back in his car. And I thought, you know, it was, for me, a very emotional time because we did what Tom liked to do and we gave him the opportunities. Doctors told us, don't expect much from Tom. He probably will never speak and he probably will never walk. And tying his shoelaces, oh my God, never. But he has proven health professionals to be wrong on so many occasions by what he has been able to do. And it's nothing special, it's just given the opportunity.
Because Tom is such a visual learner, he has to see things and see how things go and he has to process them. And I guess where we are here is we help him through that process. We provide him with the rituals. He sees what we do. We help him do what we do. And we do it often enough so that it helps him learn what it is that we're doing and perhaps process that information himself. Because I think sometimes things in our society move too quickly and we don't have time to sit down and, you know, go through things slowly and do the number of repetitions that we need to do so that we can fully process what's happening and come to terms with it ourselves.
I guess on occasion when I think my mother died, I think and then Anne's mom and dad died, we often thought, how can we explain this to Tom? And lo and behold, he seemed to have some innate awareness of death and dying, and it was as if he fully understood. Other people were showing perhaps a little more emotion, but Tom's attitude was dead, gone. And we could never understand where he did pick that up, but we're very pleased that he did have that response.
I was surprised that how well he articulated it, because you've got to remember this is a person that doesn't have a lot of language, and sometimes for him to be able to express something so concisely and so clearly, that's what impressed me, that he let us know that he understood. And that was grateful because we didn't know until then that he really understood and processed that information.
And even on that note, I know we ran into, like I say, society doesn't always provide opportunities or perhaps expect that a special needs individual is capable of doing things. We insisted Tom be a pallbearer at the funerals. And I remember in Chicago, where at the funeral of her mom and dad, the individual said, is he going to be a pallbearer? Maybe we should get someone else. I says, why? He's fully capable. He's kind of small. This is heavy. I says, well, there'd be about 6 people on the casket. And I says, Tom will be able to shoulder his load easily. And after the funeral director said to me, he says, you've got a wonderful little fellow there. He says, a strong little guy.
Can you turn the pages for me? What's this?
Bonnie.
What are you doing there?
Okay. But you're breaking cans. Yeah, you like doing that. What do we got here?
A flag.
What kind of flags?
That flag.
Canada flags, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think for all of us to be able to do something around death really is comforting. You know, the fact that we plant flowers, we're still remembering the person, that we take care of the grave, that we pour water on the flowers, that we clean it up in the fall. We're respecting the dead and respecting that person. And so I think that's the way we pass that feeling on to Tom, because he picks up on our feelings. We're not hysterical. We're not throwing ourselves on the grave. This is matter of fact. This is life, and this is what we do. If you shield someone from those life issues, they're going to surface at some point in time. And I think it's always better that you do it when you're there to support your person with a disability, or even to support your children without a disability, because that's how you teach them about life, is to let them participate and support them while they participate. And I think we all need rituals, things to do over those difficult life periods, because if we don't have the rituals, then we're at a loss. And I think maybe that's the thing our parents gave us. They needed these rituals, and they passed them on to us. And part of our church services and the things that go on around death, illness, and all of life's issues were part of what we're taught. And we weren't shielded from them, but we were given tasks to do when they occurred. We weren't just bystanders. And I think that's probably important.